comments tonight are kind of a mixed bag. You know, some positive, you know, some a little bit negative. I think that all of the hoop-de-doo about the timeline of the shelter, everybody's up in arms, but this is a direct result of the unintended consequences of changing the architect. And, John Hall's very pertinent remarks in the First Step Shelter that were disseminated on social media and the newspaper and everywhere around, it just caused a lot of people to be up in arms. The process is going to take as long as it takes, you know, and we can push for it or speed it up, but when we're talking new construction, I got a little bit of experience with that. It, you know, you got to put about 20% in there for Murphy's Law because things, you know, things happen. But I'm concerned about it is this research phase, the bringing together of the stakeholders and bringing the engineers in before we even get final construction documents. And with the timeline being 10 months, which I think is appropriate for construction, then we're, you know, maybe into 2019, maybe not. Okay, but it is what it's going to be. Now, the unintended consequences of what happened when the homeless encampment on Beach Street broke down was that Marie Hartman did an opinion that said we don't have to provide any kind of amenities for a safe zone. Well, that's technically true. Now, last year when I tried to get permission to bring in tents, the city attorney told me that anything that needs to be done as far as a safe zone or homeless encampment needs to be done by the city, and that's fine with me. So, you know, the only thing that I would want to say is that you own it. You own it. So I'm thrilled with what's going on with my conversations with Keith Capri. We've been talking and having a good talk.
Thank you, sir.
God bless you.